up, everybody, and welcome back to another Madden 21 online CFM game. It is now week 11 of the 2021 season here in the Premier Madden League. Our tour of the NFC West continues today as we get ready to go against the Los Angeles Rams. We're coming off of a nice win last week against the Seahawks. Jeff Okuda had a pretty good game, and he's looking for a great game today to go from superstar to X-Factor. Well, actually, scratch that. Jeff Okuda doesn't actually need to have a good game at all. We just need to force three turnovers as a team, and we can get Okuda from superstar to X-Factor. If we could get that done, then that'll really help develop Okuda. Not that we really need an X-Factor ability, but just as far as, you know, getting his overall higher quicker, that'll be big for us. So we're definitely going to aim for that today. We're also, of course, going to aim to try to beat the Los Angeles Rams, who enter today with a pretty futile record, but the Rams, for the most part this season, have been CPU controlled. They only just got a user. Their users only played one game so far, so it's a bit of a relative unknown. As you see, Kenny Golladay is actually available to return today, but we're going to turn down the opportunity to bring Golladay back, which honestly, I probably should have brought Golladay back just so we could at least get training, right? So we could be a part of the training, even if we don't use him on the field. But nonetheless, we're going to keep Golladay on the bench. We've been doing okay without him so far. We haven't really had any big tests. We'll see if the Rams bring anything today. As you guys see, the Rams are 0-9, and most of these stats don't really even matter because they are games that were CPU force wins, so there's not much of a scouting report. But at the same time, the scariest scouting report is no scouting report. So what do we got on our hands? Don't know. Any team with Aaron Donald and Jalen Ramsey is going to be tough to score on, you have to think, especially with Golladay out of the mix today. Our Detroit Lions are going to need to battle for every win we can possibly get on this back end of the schedule after a not so great start to the season if we want to make the playoffs once again and try to contend for the Super Bowl and all that good stuff. So here we are at Ford Field getting ready. The winless Los Angeles Rams, can they get on the board today? The Detroit Lions are hoping not. The Lions start with the ball. They'll fair catch at the 25-yard line, and DeAndre Swift up the middle. Swift nearly getting the first down. DeAndre Swift has had quite the tumultuous sophomore season. It started off really good, then he went to the bench. But now DeAndre Swift is fully back in the fold as the number one back here in Detroit as we feature him very early and often on this opening drive, trying to get something going, but not really able to run between the trenches. Third down and six, Matt Stafford downfield. That is St. Brown, who's got the catch, but not the football anymore. That's a catch and a fumble, a turnover on the opening drive in the blink of an eye. That was a very bang-bang play as far as whether St. Brown even caught the ball. I mean, whether he caught it or not, it would have been us probably punting the ball in that situation anyway, so that definitely hurt, but what are you going to do, I suppose? At least we forced the three now with our defense. The all-pro Johnny Hecker, he's going to, of course, pin us on the sidelines, but we have an opportunity to return this with Ty Johnson. Ty Johnson has now become the primary return guy instead of Jamal Agnew, as Swift trying to get sticky in the open field. He maybe got half a yard there. Second down, Stafford standing strong in the pocket as it collapsed. St. Brown's lost the ball again. They're going to call it a catch and a fumble. And for the second time, a fumble recovery. Unbelievable. Two great plays, but the rookie has coughed it up both times. Next play, that's Breshad Perriman for the touchdown. The Rams are on the board first, and the Lions are left simply scratching their heads about what has happened here. Like, how did that happen once, let alone twice? We can only attribute that to a bit of bad luck, right? Like, what else can you really do? The good news is we are moving the ball. We are connecting on our passes as Tyron Johnson makes the catch. Johnson getting more snaps with the injury to Kenny Golladay as, oh man, DeAndre Swift starting to really struggle now. Second down, Swift trying to do what he can, but he's just bouncing around, not really able to go anywhere. So now it's third down and long for Matt Stafford. The blitz off the edge is picked up. Oh, going for St. Brown one more time. This time he is not able to make the catch, so we can't fumble the ball. Just an incompletion. We'll punt the ball rather than fumbling it. And as you guys see, Amon-Ra St. Brown, definitely a big part of our passing attack without Kenny Golladay. Of course, DeAndre Swift and TJ Hawkinson figured to get involved, as well as, ooh, Cam Akers battling for that first down after the penalty. Akers and Swift were in a battle for Rookie of the Year last season. Offensive Rookie of the Year, I should say, in the NFC side. That DeAndre Swift ultimately won. So this Cam Makers feel a bit sighted? We'll find out. Oh, that's a dangerous pass to the rookie Atwell. That's going to be incomplete, but it could have been a whole lot worse. Third down. Akers with Aru Warrior all over him. As we have an injury, I believe, to one of the Rams offensive linemen. Akers is able to stretch for the first down in what has been quite the eventful first quarter, which, despite, you know, us playing pretty decently, it's all Rams right now. As you see, that's going to be a dislocated shoulder. So that's a big injury to the offensive line, as we have the first round pick, Kyle Pitts, at the tight end position. Pitts is definitely a dynamic playmaker on this Rams offense. We got to keep him in check as Cam Akers continues to get the carries. Cam Akers, the primary running back on this team, as Pitts gets the catch as we start the second quarter. The Rams looking for a two possession lead. Kellen Mond, by the way, is the quarterback. Jared Goff has simply been benched. This is Kellen Mond's offense. So the Rams 0-9, trying to experiment with the quarterback position, trying to learn what they can do for the rest of this year and future years to come, as Akers, oh my, sit down. Jeremiah Moon says, not on my watch. 4th and 3, Rams offense on the field, running the ball with Akers, and I don't think he got it. He didn't. That's the Mario Davis who just held him up. Turnover on downs. We go low to DeAndre Swift. He'll make the catch. He'll get the first down. Momentarily crisis averted. Stafford finds a wide open. Amon-Ra St. Brown makes the catch. Doesn't fumble. First down. And the rocky way this game has started has really undermined how great Matt Stafford is playing right now, as well as Amon-Ra St. Brown. 7 for 853. This is St. Brown hitting a spin move backward. That was definitely not on purpose, and lost the yard. Taysom Hill in the game. Taysom Hill battling, trying to get whatever he can. But a third down and long one more time for Matt Stafford and the offense. That's Swift for the touchdown. DeAndre Swift out the backfield making the big play, as the defense had all eyes on Amon-Ra St. Brown, who has been featured a lot early on. But hopefully now that we have St. Brown capturing all the defensive eyes, that can open up Hockenson, Swift, and whomever else, even like a Marvin Hall or Tyron Johnson. So after everything that's happened, we got the game tied up. Oh, and it nearly went back the Rams' way, but that's an overthrown open Atwell. Kellen Mond not looking too hot right there. Third down and 8 as they are going to run with the quarterback. Mond keeping, getting the first down, taking the hit from Jeff Okuda. Remember, we had that dev story. We haven't forced a turnover yet. Oh, we've nearly given up a touchdown for the second time on this drive. Tutu Atwell has to feel robbed by the lack of accuracy from his quarterback, who's been picked off on the very next play. Jeremiah Moon getting sticky. Look at him go. Need the block. Not going to get it, but nonetheless, a game changing play by the rookie linebacker Jeremiah Moon, as DeAndre Swift trying to battle as this second quarter winds down. We'll try to manage the clock as well as we can, but if there's a play for a touchdown, we'll go for it and we'll get it. Tyron Johnson, he comes down with the jump ball. Not a great pass from Matt Stafford, but Tyron pretty tall, able to go up for it, and we get ourselves a 7-point lead. So all we had to do in this game, you know, was just not lose our cool after the way things started off, knowing that we were playing well. It's just that, you know, we're kind of catching bad breaks. Eventually, you know, that stuff will even out. 10-minute quarters, long time for, you know, to balance the shift. Third down and 8. Now the Rams have their back against the wall, and Kellen Mond, he's going to try to scramble for the first down. He'll get it. He gets chopped by Aru Warrior. That'll take us to the 2-minute warning. Rams with a new set of downs. Aru Warrior misses Akers that time around. He'll run to the 45-yard line, but Akers hasn't done too much so far today. As look downfield, that is Robert Woods covered by Will Harris, and that is turnover number 2 forced by this Lions defense. We only need one more turnover to get Jeff Okuda from superstar to X-Factor. As Stafford, he'll say, he'll wait, he'll fire, he'll go downfield, he'll hit DeAndre Swift. The Lions are roaring downfield. 40 seconds left in the first half. Clean pocket, Stafford, once St. Brown, but As you notice, the Rams have put Jalen Ramsey, their primary corner, on our primary receiver. There's our big-time running back, DeAndre Swift, up the middle to the 5-yard line. First time out of the half by the Lions. This will be DeAndre Swift battling, and as he always does, battling for every yard at the goal line until he gets the touchdown. Hey, man, that's the one thing about DeAndre Swift. He will fight to get that touchdown. And more often than not, he reaches that ball. And now we have a 7-21 lead and pretty good control of this game. But, you know, one thing that has been an Achilles heel for us, for whatever reason, is our defense in about the last 30 seconds of halves. And we nearly had this thing wrapped up, but Kyle Pitts is able to get the first down. So we need to make sure we don't give up any points, not even a field goal. Let's not blow any coverages, do anything silly. Play action for Kellen Mond. It'll go downfield to Perriman, who makes the catch at the 50-yard line. And for whatever reason, you know, this is when, you know, offenses gash us, and they get 20-yard gain. Next thing you know, they're close to field goal range. Next thing you know, they'll go downfield to Breshad Perriman for the touchdown. That is definitely not what the doctor ordered. A true mistake there by myself, trying to set up the defense. And sometimes when you try to make defensive adjustments, as the ball is hiked, you see the way my guy flailed, because I was trying to make all these defensive adjustments, and ended up just blowing the coverage right there. So definitely not what we wanted in that situation. That was literally the only thing we couldn't give up. And we did it as Stafford hits, he throws, gets it off to DeAndre Swift, and that will be the end of the first half. So in the interest of time and the lack of time and how much time we have missed with this series, no halftime show, because we are very far behind right now. And quite frankly, I'm not sure I could dig up many highlights from the CFM, because it's been over a month since this game was played. Over a month and a half, I would say. Oh, Jeremiah Moon had that one targeted, but Cam Akers able to shake him off. Third down and 5 for the Rams, who are suddenly right back into this game. But now they've turned it over to Julian Okwara, and that is the last turnover needed. That should get Jeff Okuda to X-Factor development. And an X-Factor ability, we'll see hopefully what that is at the end of the game, as Stafford downfield. Ooh! Once again, Jalen Ramsey in the area, shadowing St. Brown. The rookie has a tough task for the rest of this game. DeAndre Swift up the middle, third down and 10, sneaking a trap run, get the first down, but there is an injury to the backup tight end, Hunter Henry. We'll keep an eye on that. In the meantime, play action for Stafford outside. Ooh! Hawkinson nearly had it. Ramsey nearly had it. Second down, it'll be Swift on the ground one more time. He's had a very uneven game, 11 for 61. Some of them have been great, some of them not so much. Strained tricep, that should be out for the game for Hunter Bryant, but not much longer than that as we run the ball with Taysom Hill. Bit of a conservative play call there, trying to see if we could sneak something in, but not so much. So we end up kicking the field goal. We get ourselves a 2-possession lead. At this point, you know, just don't want to blow these coverages, because we did nearly give up 2 touchdowns to Tutu Atwell a couple of drives ago. We gave up a 1 touchdown just now. We've given up a huge catch to Kyle Pitts. We just got to make the Rams, you know, check it down, think and dunk, and hopefully force them into a mistake. If we keep giving up these gashing plays, we're going to get into a shootout, and that's not really what we want, like, to say the least, because that's going to put too much pressure on our offense to try to stay perfect as Atwell gets the sweep for the first down. That's going to be a sack for DeMario Davis. That's the big play that our defense needed to shift the momentum on this drive. Will Harris continues to have a great stretch of the last few games. He gets the big hit there. It's third down and 11, and Kellen Mond is rolling and throwing to Cam Akers for the first down. Although we had that play all sorts of boxed up, but someone had a misassignment on their coverage there and just left Akers open and went to the quarterback. So that was just a big mistake by our defense that keeps the drive alive. Cam Akers, he'll battle for every yard. That's one thing Cam Akers has been good at in this game. He is getting the extra couple of yards. Instead of a third down and 3, it's third down and 1. It is going to now be a third down and 6. That's a false start on the Rams offensive line. Kellen Mond, the young quarterback, trying to do a bit too much at the line of scrimmage. Now here's Jared Goff in the game. Interesting here. He goes to Akers, who nearly gets the first down. Nearly gets it, but he doesn't. It's going to be fourth down and 1. The Rams are going to keep the offense on the field with Goff. Akers in the backfield. Goff taking his time at the line, and he's going to go to Akers. Open gap to run for the first down and easily go in for the touchdown as well. We really have a ball game on our hands. And you know, a game against the 0-9 Rams, like I said, we didn't know what to expect from the Rams, and I think we know what to expect. The Rams offense has been pretty dynamic so far. So, you know, we got our hands full in this one. 24 points is not going to get the job done. I'm not even sure if we score one more touchdown, even that's going to get the job done. So we really got to keep up. And, you know, we put ourselves in this position to be involved in a shootout. So let's go downfield. Amon-Ra St. Brown, have yourself a day. He'll fly by wrap and go 80. 5 yards for the Detroit Lions touchdown. St. Brown well over 1,000 yards in his rookie campaign and has been very busy the last couple of weeks from the injury to Kenny Golladay. He's been the guy and he is making plays for us time and time again. Was he going to hit the rookie wall without Kenny Golladay taking away a lot of the defensive coverage? That was a question. I think we have our answers. Cam Akers up the middle. Easy gain of 20. It's not just easy plays. These are easy plays that are getting first downs, even on checkdowns. This defense is just bleeding yardage right now. Is at least in the rushing attack, we're limiting Cam Akers for the most part. But when Kellen Mond is airing that ball out, bad things happen for us. Akers gets the edge. Akers, I believe, flipped for the first down. Yes, he did. And that play looked like it was bottled up. And that's just the way our defense has been playing right now. But all we really need is one stop. Even if we hold him to a field goal, just don't give up the touchdown. Oh, no, no. Can barely even get that sentence out before Kyle Pitts is wide open. Second time this game that the same thing happened. Trying to set up the defense and, you know, as I'm trying to set up the defense, I just so happen to be on the guy in the deep coverage that's supposed to be there. Kyle Pitts gets the touchdown, and yeah, 31 points is definitely not going to get the job done the way we are playing. So, got to go back to work. But now, how many more plays can we play well on? Matt Stafford is having a phenomenal game, but Stafford usually is good for that one turnover a game. Whether it's real life or in the Premier Madden League, he's good for one turnover, and sometimes at the worst possible time. So, third down, we're going to give it to DeAndre Swift, who's got the first down, who's got a lot of yardage to work with afterwards. Hitting the spin move, getting to the 43-yard line. We'll go back to the ground attack. This will be Marquez Stevenson getting the carry. Stevenson to the 34-yard line. The ground attack starting to feature well for us. That's going to open up TJ Hawkinson up the middle. Hawkinson to the 3-yard line. Quite the drive being put together by the Lions outside. Easy touchdown, DeAndre Swift. Now we need the defense to hold once. Just one stop, and we should be able to secure the victory and keep the winning streak alive. But easier said than done. The Rams have developed a good stash of offensive weapons with Pitts, with Akers, with Tutu Atwell. Kellen Mond is definitely getting out of the early game jitters that he was suffering from. Now he's absolutely on fire, locked in. Okay, we might have jinxed Kellen Mond. Sorry about that, Rams. Second down and 10, pick up where you left off. Kellen Mond, he's going to roll. He's going to run for the first down. That was a fearless scramble by the young quarterback. 4 minutes left. Downfield, it's Pitts again. Kyle Pitts is torching the Lions defense time and time again. The Rams one more time with the answer. For the Rams, they got to be thinking, when is this defense going to get a stop? When is this defense going to help us out besides forcing a fumble, right? At this point, it could just be whoever has the ball last. And hopefully for us, it's our Detroit Lions. Hopefully, you know, we can take away a couple of minutes here. Slow the tempo down. It's going a little bit too fast. We go play action on first down. Oh, Swift. See, he's going to stay in bounds. Is he really? Yes, he is. What a play by DeAndre Swift. And now Devontae Freeman, formerly on the Los Angeles Rams earlier this year. He makes a play for our Detroit Lions there. Swift at the backfield. That's a big first down. And we'll see if the Rams call a timeout here. They should, but they won't. So we're going to bleed about 35 seconds and go to the 2-minute warning. A big mistake by the Los Angeles Rams. That's pretty much 35 free seconds that they gave us. So we'll take that. Now at this point, every first down, oh so critical, as we're going to run outside with DeAndre Swift. Got to stay in bounds, which we do. Got to make sure we don't fumble the ball, which has been an issue for Swift. So we got to protect the football. Two hands on that ball as we're actually going to run a jet sweep to St. Brown. Oh, look at him battle. Amon-Ra St. Brown actually got a couple extra yards. We'll see how valuable that's going to be as the Rams call their second and three timeouts. A first down here will end the game. We're going to put the game in Matt Stafford's hands. He's our guy. He's our quarterback. We're not going to play it safe. We're going to go for the dagger right here. right now. With a minute 45 left, Matt Stafford, play action. He's going to have to go quick. He does, and he's got T.J. Hockenson for the first down and the ball game. No timeouts left for the Los Angeles Rams. A couple of quarterback kneels from Chase Daniels will solidify the deal, and the Detroit Lions continue their winning ways and keeping the Los Angeles Rams winless in 2021, but not without a valiant effort. GG's to the Los Angeles Rams. They put up as good of a battle as you possibly can, despite, you know, those turnovers from Kellen Mond. But once he got heated up in that second half, he was pretty much unstoppable. As you see, DeAndre Swift nearly going over 100 yards rushing, 2 touchdowns. So that's a pretty productive day for sophomore Swift. Matt Stafford was really the star of the show today. He was an absolute gunslinger, nearly going 400 yards, and a nearly flawless game besides a couple of times going in Jalen Ramsey's direction. Matt Stafford, what a weapon for this Lions attack. You wonder when Matt Stafford's going to fall off. With Amon-Ra St. Brown as a primary weapon, Matt Stafford might be able to extend his prime just a bit longer. So that's going to do it for today's video. For the most part, except we got to check in on that X Factor for Jeff Okuda. So yeah, we'll do that. But you know, I just want to say it's good to be back here, back with the CFM. We're going to be rapidly uploading the next couple of CFM videos so we could kind of catch up to where we are, because present time, the CFM is in season 3. This is season 2 right now. So yeah, we got a lot of catching up to do. We're going to do it very quickly. So hop aboard. Let's go. Chugga chugga choo choo. And we're going to do it with the help of Jeff Okuda and his X Factor. As you see, Amon-Ra St. Brown developing quite well. He is over an 80 overall. We drafted St. Brown as a 70. He's now over an 80. He's a superstar. Okuda was a superstar already when we inherited his team. Now he's an X Factor. And we'll see what his X Factor ability is. And we'll see if he can get an upgrade with that 4,000 XP earned. So leave a like on this video if you guys enjoyed what you guys saw today. 1,000 XP for the offensive line. We'll take that as well. Subscribe for more Madden videos if you guys want to keep up with this Lions online CFM. We have one upgrade for Okuda, and we have the X Factor ability of Selfless, which is like, really, Madden? But yeah, Okuda's really starting to develop into his own, so hopefully we can take that Selfless off and put something else on. That's up to the commissioners of the league. You gotta, like, ask them for permission to change it, so all random CFM politics that I'll just put to the side now, and we'll wrap this one up. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you guys next time.